Hi, this is Danica, and I design WordPress membership sites. And in this video, we're gonna continue in this LearnDash LMS tutorial series. For this video, we will start adding courses in this demo site that we have. So first, to create a course in LearnDash, there is two buttons. One is create from the video playlist, and one is to add new. Now, example here, if I'm gonna say create a course from a video playlist, it says you can use a YouTube playlist, a Vimeo showcase, or a Wistia project URL to create a LearnDash course in few minutes. Now let's try this out, and then we are gonna also use the other button, which is the add new, to like create a course from the ground and see the difference. So I found I'm gonna use this LearnDash, create a LearnDash course playlist that they have from YouTube, and I'm gonna grab the URL as instruction from here. So you can use YouTube playlist URL, and I'm gonna paste that in here, and then this button highlighted and it says load data from YouTube. So I'm gonna do that. That doesn't work on the first click. I'm gonna try again. So it says the course, creating a LearnDash course, will be created with 10 lessons. So let's just check in here. So yes, there's 10 videos. So that's correct. And then it says how users will gain access to this course. I'm gonna set this to free, so that they still need to register even if the course is free. We're gonna discuss about different protection in here in a bit. And then next is how users will interact with the content. It's either linear form or free form. Let's just check. I think I'm gonna allow a free form, so they could start from anywhere. So they could start from here before they start here. I don't think that matter for this example. But linear form, it will require them to start from the top and then move to the next step and to the next step. So I think I'm all good here. So I'm gonna click the create the course button. So if I view this, so it says create a LearnDash course, and I have some videos in order. Let's just check. So it actually also did not follow the order that was in here. So whatever the order is in the playlist will not be replicated when you import it using that process or method. So you need to organize or order this the way you want to, if you have specific order or if you want to follow what you have in here. But again, that works and that's great. So that's the first one, create from video playlist. So that's how you could create a course using the create from video list. In the next video, we're gonna use this add new button.